Welcome back guys, today we'll be continuing and we'll be learning about laser. So today we'll be seeing the working principle of a laser. So let me write the principle on which it is based. So the principle of production is of laser will be based on for production. It will be based on the phenomena of stimulated emission with addition to stimulated with emission addition to spontaneous emission. So these two are the two processes that we will take in consideration. So first of all, in lasing process there should be an active medium. Active medium means states, that is solid, liquid or gas. So this is the active state, which should be such that it should have a third state. It should have a third state, at least third state. Third state, or which we call it as a metastable state, called as metastable state. So let me underline it. This is most very important. This is a metastable state. So besides this will be the extra state, besides the normal excited and ground level state. So this is also a non-radiating state. Non-radiating state. So the lifetime of, as we have, I have told already, the lifetime of an atom in the excited state was 10 to the power minus 8 seconds. But here the lifespan or lifetime in the metastable state will be greater than the excited state. So the metastable, so in metastable state an atom can stay longer than its excited state. Why I am telling this? All these things will be covered and understood later in this video. This is important. So now we see that how, let me draw the energy based diagram so it will understand it very precisely. So suppose these are two basic energy states. Let me call it as the ground state, and this will be our excited state. Excited state, and our third state, which is called the metastable state, will lie somewhere here. And now, so let me rename it as a metastable state. Metastable state. So now we see that when atoms, we consider an atom, we consider atom of suitable wavelength. And the atoms in the lower energy state, that is E1, jumps to the excited state E2 by the absorption of photons. So this will travel here now, but the atom can remain in the excited state for a limited time, that is 10 to the power minus 8 of seconds. So due to small lifetime, so the atom, as soon as the atoms drop back by spontaneous emission, many of them will be trapped in the metastable state. So where its lifetime is greater than 10 to the power minus 8 seconds than the excited state. So let me draw an arrow. Many of the atoms will get trapped here. So here atoms will get trapped, and we can see that the atoms are trapped here. Now, so there exists, so a large number of atoms will be trapped here. So there exists a large number of atoms in the metastable state, and the ground, in the ground state there are very few atoms. There will be atoms here, after that it will go here. So there will be more atoms in the ground state, provided that the pumping of light is intense enough. So pumping, it is an important term, I will explain it now. So and the process of this, and the whole process of this, is known as population inversion. So let me complete the diagram. What will happen next? After that, by stimulated emission, all will come down and will emit photons, and this is our laser transition. So now let me explain population inversion. What is this? So population inversion is an artificial situation, that is, we have created it man-made, that is established by generating a large number of atoms in the higher state than the lower state, and the process of doing this is known as pumping. Pumping means we are pumping atoms from the higher state, and we are taking this as a lower reference and it goes to the higher state via this process. So this is known as pumping, and the whole process is known as population inversion. So now we see that the population inversion is achieved, and the photon, now spontaneous emission takes place. A photon is obtained by spontaneous emission and is made to strike the atoms in, spontaneous emission takes place. This process is continuous, as we know that it will go on, and here atoms are staying here and spontaneous emission is still taking place. So the spontaneous emission will strike the atoms of the metastable state, and the excited atom of the metastable state is now has been stimulated to emit photon of the same energy as that of the stimulating photon. Now the stimulating and the stimulated photons passing through the atoms of the metastable state yield a large number of coherent photons by repeated stimulated emission. So it will be something like this. So photon comes here, strikes the metastable state, it generates more photons. Since this is a continuous process, now it will be multiples of photons will get emitted. So all are h mu. So here amplification takes place. Now we see that large number of photons will be emitted, and the multiplication of photon takes place, and light will amplify it. So amplification will get started. These photons have the same frequency, as we have already told, and will have the same direction, all will travel in the same direction and will have the same phase because it is coherent. Hence a strong beam will be produced. This will be known as our laser. So this was our whole working principle of laser. So if you had any problems, comment below, and if you did like my video, hit the thumbs up button and subscribe to my channel for more videos. Thank you.